There's nothing harder than being asked what your favorite of something is, be it books, movies, or, of course, video games. A rush of choices always floods my head and I can never pick. So, I became the kind of person who makes lists. Lots of lists. And these lists are always changing. One day I might be in a Borderlands 2 mood. On another day, I might really be feeling Werewolf the Last Warrior for the NES. I mean, come on, just listen to that music. However, there is one game that has remained constant in my top three of all time since I first played it, and that is Double Fine's masterpiece, Psychonauts. So, with the long-awaited sequel on its way, I thought I'd take a look back and reflect on what I consider to be one of the greatest levels in gaming history. Psychonauts is like a gift that keeps on giving. I've played it probably between 20 and 30 times now, and every time, to this day, I discover new things that I've never seen before. Beautiful little character moments, hilarious jokes, and of course, memorable lines. I've even beaten the game using a Guitar Hero controller, but that's a story for another day. Now, like I said, choosing a favorite can be hard. I've always had a soft spot for Glorious Theater, a level which gets a lot of hate, but I know Tim Schafer likes it, and, well, I've got the Schafer's back. Then, there is of course the absolutely brilliant design of Black Velvetopia. And who can forget Lungfishopolis? But there is one level that for many fans stands out among the pack. A level that is a perfect combination of comedy, design, character, and emotion. I'm of course talking about the Meat Circus. Oh, come on. Of course not. It's the Milkman Conspiracy. The Milkman Conspiracy is arguably the most memorable and insane level of Psychonauts. It serves as an introduction to a new section of the game, and totally boggles the player's mind with winding paths and a conspiracy that spans the neighborhood of an insane man's mind. I'm talking about you, Boyd. Now, for those of you who haven't played the game, and I mean if you haven't, I'm upset with you. I'm going to be talking spoilers here, so if you don't want to get spoiled, put down the video and go play the dang game. Okay, let's get into it. The Milkman Conspiracy takes place inside the mind of Boyd Cooper, a security guard for the asylum where the second half of Psychonauts takes place. Boyd is a bit of a conspiracy fanatic, and he also holds the key to the asylum, which our hero Raz needs. So, as one does in the Psychonauts universe, you enter into Boyd's mind, and this is what you find. A spiraling neighborhood full of G-men, intrigue, and of course, the rainbow squirts. Boyd is in search of the Milkman, who is supposedly dead, but Boyd doesn't believe it, and neither do the G-men. So Raz goes in search of the Milkman's whereabouts, while the G-men try to stop him at every turn. This, of course, leads down a strange rabbit hole to find out who the Milkman really is, and why his milk is so delicious. Through a fair bit of puzzle solving and a run-in with a sniper, Raz discovers that the Milkman is still alive and is being protected by the Rainbow Squirts. Does anyone else find little girls creepy? Well, the Rainbow Squirts creep me out. They're basically just Girl Scouts, but as it turns out, instead of cookies, they sell explosives, and they're basically a cult in charge of protecting the Milkman's location. The final boss of the level is the Den Mother, who's the leader of the Rainbow Squirts, and I assume a soccer mom. She throws knitting needles and explosive cookies at you, and halfway through the battle introduces a pretty cool boss mechanic. At the start of the Milkman Conspiracy, Raz gets the clairvoyance ability, which is used throughout the level to look through the eyes of certain characters. Once the Den Mother's health has been reduced, the lights go out, and Raz has to use the clairvoyance to look through the Den Mother's eyes to see her location. It's a pretty cool and original idea. The level ends with the Den Mother being defeated, and the Milkman rising to deliver his milk. The milk that everyone wants. The milk that the world deserves. Now that I've gone through the plot of this level, it's time to answer the question. What makes this level perfect? Let's start with level design. Try imagining what a crazy man's mind looks like. Spirals probably come to mind. Well, that's what this level is. It's a massive neighborhood that spirals around, with each loop bringing new points of interest and challenges. The main challenge of the level is finding your way around the G-Men. Each group of G-Men holds a different object which corresponds to their quote-unquote disguise. Raz needs to find that object, which makes the G-Men think he is one of them, so they let him through. This is pretty standard game design so far, but what sets the Milkman Conspiracy ahead of other levels is the organization. Due to the spiraling world, there's a lot of going forward and backtracking to be done. Enough so that it feels like you as the player are going crazy, but it isn't annoying though. No pedestrian traffic. Whenever you complete a task, it's actually a complete joy to move back through the level. That's one of the most amazing things about this level, but of course, in true Psychonauts fashion, this level design wouldn't be possible without the script. Do you have a friend who's a huge conspiracy theorist? Are you the conspiracy theorist? Well, Boyd is for sure, and his mind shows it. It's racked with paranoia and intrigue. Taking the time to talk to people or just stopping and listening really pays off. There is some truly hilarious dialogue to be had. You could listen to Boyd go off on strange tangents.
The dairy industry in conjunction with...
Huh? The military industrial complex?
I'm telling you, I don't know where the milkman is.
You can listen to several G-Men explain their jobs.
I'm gonna walk through, okay?
Sorry, we widows are busy grieving in here. Unless you have water for my plants, then we have no use for you in here.
I am making a pie.
I hope you are not trying to steal my husband, tramp. Aha, do you not realize that we are deadly assassins? Are you not afraid?
And of course, this level is home to one of the greatest lines in video game history.
That fact. What have you done? He wakes!
I am the milkman. My milk is delicious.
Absolutely gold. The game's script, written by Tim Schafer and Eric Wolpaw, is just filled to the brim with exquisite dialogue. The best part is that there's so much of it that it's damn near impossible to hear it all in one playthrough, unless you're really going for a 100% playthrough. As a side note, the level also does a great job blending in references to real-life conspiracies. The sniper I mentioned earlier? Located in a book depository? JFK anyone? I'm also 90% certain that the name Boyd Cooper is a reference to the famous plane hijacker DB Cooper, but I'm not certain. And finally, let's talk about the music. Peter McConnell, the game's composer, does a great job setting a tone for this level. When you think of spy and mystery movies, you have a certain idea for music that could be used. Most likely, you think of the theme from Peter Gunn. But what is so great about this level's music is that it blends all of the ideas of the level into the song. You've got this jaunty little melody of life in the neighborhood with undertones of something sinister lying right beneath it. It's the perfect mix of suburban life with existential dread, which sounds like an ideal Tuesday night to me. Psychonauts is full of amazing levels, each deserving of a video of their own. And who knows, maybe I'll make another one of these sometime. But the point is, if you're an aspiring game designer looking for inspiration, look no further than the masterpiece that is The Milkman Conspiracy. What's your favorite level? Tell me in the comments below, and let's get some frickin' hype for Psychonauts 2. I hope you enjoyed the video. Subscribe for more, and I will see y'all next week. Peace out, everyone. I'll catch you on the flip side.